ladies and gentlemen, Garry Moore.
Thank you. Hi. Excuse me, I have a small problem on my hands. Young fella, aren't you in my place?
That's right, Barrymore.
Barrymore? That's not my name. My name is Garry Moore.
Well, whatever it is, it don't matter to me. I'm taking over. I'm the new MC.
You're the new MC?
Mm-hmm, yeah. The producers are trying something new. We're trying to get a little less class into the program.
I never heard of such a thing.
Well, you mean you never heard of such a thing. Your grammar is atrocious.
It's atrocious?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm sorry about that. Well, if you're going to sit there, then I'll just reach over and grab my cards and do the show from here.
Come on! Yeah.
Ooh, that hurt.
Cool it, buddy. I know you're a boating man, but I don't think you like it at the bottom of the river, huh?
Well, how would you like it if I hit you on the hand?
That wouldn't hurt me a bit. But it might hurt the guy under this desk. He's my boss.
The guy under the desk?
Yeah.
What do you say we meet the guy under the desk? He is America's favorite puppeteer. Say hello to Bill Baird. Bill, come on up here. How are you, Bill?
I'm fine, Garry.
It's been much too long.
Yes, sir.
You have a special reason for being with us today, aside from your own joyful presence. You want to tell us what it is?
Yes, I do. My son is on the program, and we're going to be working together here on the program.
And Peter is going to be our first guest?
He's going to be our first guest, yes.
Well, don't tell anybody which one he is, because that's up to the panel to find out.
I really don't know myself.
It's a wise son who knows his own father.
Certainly
and
is.
Like that.
It certainly is, Garry. Yes,
all right,
yes.
Bill. We'll see Bill Baird and his puppets and young Peter a little later on in the show. And thank you,
and
Bill
remember,
Baird.
My name is Garry Moore.
As I say, we will have all those shenanigans coming up as soon as we say hello to our panel here on To Tell the Truth.
Bill Cullen. Peggy Cass. Mark Goodson. And the wife of the Attorney General of the United States, Martha Mitchell.
Well, gracious, we're generating a certain amount of excitement around here today, aren't we? First of all, we better do a countdown on the panel because we're all... Well, we got fine people here today. Way down the end, we've got our good boss and frequent visitor to the show, Mark Goodson.
Thank you. Thank you. Good job. Garry,
yeah.
As you know, I'm here in honor of our special guest.
Certainly, and that, of course, would be Peggy Cass.
Of course.
Who's sitting right next to Mark.
All faithful.
And yeah. Next to Peggy, we've got Bill Cullen.
The other one.
And then a lady who Johnny introduced as the wife of the Attorney General, but she is certainly a celebrity in her own right. Say hello to Martha Mitchell. You never played a game show on television before,
did
you?
No, I haven't. I'm looking forward to it.
Well, listen, you're sitting next to the right fella. If you get in any trouble, ask Bill Cullen.
He'll get me out of it.
No, he doesn't know how to play the game either.
That's right.
It's not going to help you a bit. Well, now that we all know who we are, let's find out what's going to happen back here on the stage. Let's meet Bill Baird's son.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Peter Baird.
Number two.
My name is Peter Baird.
Number three.
My name is Peter Baird.
And, of course, only one of them really is Peter Baird. The other two are lying. And this is what the affidavit says. I, Peter Baird, am a puppeteer. My father, Bill Baird, is probably America's most famous puppeteer. He has his own theater in New York City, and I have not only worked with him there, but on tours all around the country. I have done every conceivable job involved in putting on puppet shows. I have been a ticket taker, an usher, and a stagehand. I have also assisted my father in preparing the simulation of the space flight of Apollo 13 that you all saw on television. Although I only became a full-fledged puppeteer about 4 months ago, I literally grew up with a puppet in my hand. My father started me working with sock puppets when I was only 5 years old. Signed, Peter Baird. We'll try to find out which one is the real Baby Bear after we have a few commercials. Now, remember that all three of these young men claim to be Peter Baird, son of Bill Baird, and a puppeteer in his own right. And let's begin the questioning with a guy who I hope today is no dummy, Mr. Bill Cullen.
I want to thank you for that vote of confidence, Garry.
Nicest thing I can think of to say.
I hope so, too. Number two, what is a sock puppet? Is it what the name implies?
It's just a sock that you put your hand inside and with your thumb and four fingers, make a mouth.
Number three, when you first started to do puppet shows for, I guess you did it with the kids in the neighborhood, how old were you?
I was about 4 years old when I started doing puppetry.
Two short questions. All right, thank you, Bill. We go to Martha Mitchell.
Number one, tell me something about the history of puppets.
Well, puppets are about as old as time. They started back in the Orient and India were about the oldest puppets, and they've come along all through the years in all our cultures.
And what are the various different kinds, number one?
Well, there are string puppets, also known as marionettes, and they're the hand puppets, the sock puppets, and then there's the pole puppets, the kind that are up on the pole that are controlled by strings.
Number three.
That seems rude, but that's the way it goes, Martha. We're going to go on down to Mark Goodson.
Martha Mitchell is excellent.
She got two questions in
there.
That's
right.
All the time.
Number one, what are some of the other kinds of puppets besides sock puppets? I mean,
well, as I said, the marionettes, which are the string type that come down from the top, and then the pole marionettes that come up from the bottom that also are controlled by strings from the bottom.
Number two, name some of your father's little characters, the names of the puppets.
Charlemagne, Brushface, Alibaba.
Number three, what was the name of this little puppet that was out here a while ago?
I believe that was Brushface.
That was Brushface.
Thanks, Mark and Peggy Cass.
Number one, who runs Madame Oglepuss?
I'm sorry?
Madame Oglepuss.
I don't know.
Thank you. Number three, who runs the Cookie Monster?
That's on Sesame Street. I believe that's the Muppets.
Thank you. And number one, is a dummy like Mortimer Snerd, no offense intended, considered a puppet?
Excuse me, I didn't understand.
Number two, is Mortimer Snerd considered a puppet?
Yes, I'd say it would be.
Thank you. Number one, in fairy stories, which was the very famous little boy who was in actuality a puppet?
And who was that addressed, Peggy?
One.
Number one.
Are you talking about Davy Jones?
Gee, I thought he was human.
He got off a big locker, that's all I know. But anyhow, on the basis of that, we must mark our ballots. Martha and the rest of the guests, if you'll take your little card and put a number down on it, then I'll call on you for your vote. And what would you do at home? Would you vote for number one? Or would you vote for number two? Or would you vote for number three? In any event, it would cost you $50 for a wrong vote, $500 if all of the votes are wrong. And Bill Cullen starts, please.
Well, I don't know. I had 103 questions left over, and because of that, I voted for number three. He's my choice.
You did a three.
Uh-huh.
All right.
And I did a three, Garry.
Just because Bill did a three?
Oh, yes. I'm taking my...
Well, that's your first mistake.
Well, we can see how this week is going to go. You're going to buddy up with him, right?
Sure. I'm sitting here holding his hand.
You don't let go of him. Let's go down to Mark.
Well, the questioning period was too short to make a definite judgment, but I went by the sensitive look of number two and voted for him. I figure he's a creative puppeteer.
One vote for sensitivity. It's a two and two threes, and Peggy, sure.
Well, Madame Oglepuss is Bert Tilstrom, and Pinocchio is the fairy story puppet, so I thought since number two knew everything, it was number two.
So, there you go. You got a couple of them up there, a couple of pairs, and what do you think at home? Let's find out. Will the real Peter Baird please stand up? Hello. Thank you, Peter. Peter, don't get too comfortable because I want you to go off stage and join your dad. They're going to do a marvelous act together for the first time on television, by the way. So if you go out and join your famous father, we'll find out about your imposters. So number one, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Peter Troop. I'm an advertising account executive for SSC&B on the Lipton Tea account.
Good shot. Number three, sir, you got two wrong votes. What is your real name? What do you do?
My name is Bill Turk, and I'm a student at the Franklin School in Manhattan.
Well, as Mark Goodson said, our questioning period was brief. It's because we wanted to allow time for you to see, for the first time on television, two generations of Bairds, Bill and his son Peter, working together for the first time here on TV. And they're going to do portions of a dueling scene that they originally did with Andre Kostolanitz and the New York Philharmonic. Going to embarrass either my panel or myself by asking if anyone is old enough to remember when the majority of people used to work 6 days a week.
Yeah?
No answer.
Oh.
I remember because I used to work 6 days a week.
I still do in the theater.
Do you? Of course you do. Of course you do.
But most... 7 days a week.
You work 7 days a week? You mean now?
No.
Your husband works eight.
Eight and a half.
Eight and a half. Well, our next guest is an authority on a new phenomenon. It's called the four-day work week, and we'll meet her in a moment right after we take a coffee break. And now let us meet our four-day work week expert.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Riva Poor.
Number two.
My name is Riva Poor.
Number three.
My name is Riva Poor.
All righty, which one's the real one? Here is Riva Poor's story. It goes like this. I, Riva Poor, am here to say that the four-day, 40-hour work week has arrived. This burgeoning movement has already captured the hearts of people in manufacturing, retailing, and service industries. Extra time off is a real boon to employee morale. What's more, it's important to remember that since the worker still puts in his 40 hours, his salary remains the same. On the other side of the coin, companies benefit through improved staff output, They save on production costs, and they have better customer as well as employee relations. I, along with 14 other industrial experts, have compiled an in-depth report on the experiences of 36 companies who have adopted this new work regimen. Such questions as who's doing it, why, how, and with what results are all answered in a new book entitled, aptly enough, 4 Days, 40 Hours, signed Riva Poor. And we'll start the questioning with a gal whose mind works 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and then some, Peggy Cass.
Never on Sundays, my dear. Number two, how do the people employ their time off? Do you think they employ it fruitfully, or they just hang around the house and get bored? Number two.
Well, I suppose some would, but with 3 days, you could really do so much in the way of getting to the seashore, or the lake, or wherever one might want to go, and get your chores done on Friday.
Thank you. Now, number three, people usually like to have overtime. Are there any kind of like grumblings about not being able to get the overtime anymore?
No, because the normal work day for 5 days is 8 hours. That amounts to 35 hours. Now the
sorry, there goes the buzzer. We go to Bill Cullen.
Oh, you know, Peggy brought up a very real problem. Number one, I'll direct it to you. Are we not having difficulty now finding what to do in all this spare time that the four-day work week affords us?
Well, I always hear experts talk about other people having difficulty in using their time, but never themselves, so I really wonder whether there's any difficulty.
Number three, isn't it more or less common sense that if you have 3 days with nothing at all to do, no obligations, that it's going to be more expensive for you, your total 7 day week, that you
no.
have?
Actually, Mr. Cullen, the amount of transportation is cut down. You don't have commuting twice a day. And we don't like...
And there goes the buzzer, which carries us on to Martha Mitchell.
Number three, what major corporations are using this now?
Number three?
I beg your pardon.
What major corporations are using this 4 hour?
There are 63 in the United States, and the first one was the Cullen Manufacturing Company in Massachusetts.
Number one, how long did it take you to write this book?
There were 15 of us who wrote it. It took 4 months, so that amounts to almost 4 man-years of labor.
Number 4 man-years of labor.
Yeah, that's a long time.
That is a long time. Number two.
We're going to go on down to Mark Goodson.
Number one, how did you get involved with this yourself? How did you happen to start researching this area?
Well, our company was looking for a book to publish, and we wanted something that we felt would be a real contribution and catch on quickly, so we picked this topic.
Number three, have you ever worked yourself in other jobs? And
yes.
Yes?
I had a concession in the beginning, a small sandwich shop in college.
Number two, what are the attitude of the unions to this? Wouldn't they like to cut all the hours down to 30 hours a week?
32 is what they're talking about. But right now, the Chrysler Corporation and their labor union are discussing a pilot program to experiment with a 4 day week, and it should be a forerunner of what's to come.
And the little bell tells us that that's all the questioning time we have, and on the basis of what we've learned, we have to mark our ballots. And we mark them for number one, or for number two, or for number three. We pay $50 for each wrong guess. We pay $500 if nobody knows who the right one is. And Peggy Cass, you start, please.
Well, I don't know. I think that they're all very good, but number one so amazed me by that it took 4 hours, 4 years to write that little book that I voted for. Who could make up a lie like that?
I think that's good thinking. It's full of statistics, though, and statistics take time, and they're hard to say, too. So we've got one for one, and Bill Cullen, who are you voting for?
That's a good point, Peggy. I hadn't thought of that. Well, actually, four man years to write, that's a skinny book.
Yeah?
Yeah, in 4 man years, I figured they were working a 1 day week. Right? So one from four is three, and for that reason, I voted for number three as a person. Well, you know, what do I know?
All right, so we got one for one and one for three. And Martha, you going to go along with Peggy or Bill?
I'm going along with Peggy this time. I think one looks official.
How about that? All right, Bill, you have been abandoned.
Yeah.
Mark Goodson, you're on your own.
This time, I have a feeling that Martha Mitchell is absolutely right by instinct, but I voted for number three on my own original hunch.
So it's two for one and two for three, and aren't we going to be embarrassed if it turns out to be number two?
Yes,
indeed, yes.
Let's find out. Will the real Riva Poor, please stand up. Oh. Thank you, Riva. Good girl, Martha. You zoomed right in. Let's find out about our imposters. Number two, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Dorothy Liptak. I'm a fiber consultant for DuPont, and I promote their new silk-like fiber, Kiana.
And number three, with two wrong votes, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Patricia Hall. I'm doing nightclub work, and I've just finished doing the lead in Cabaret, the Broadway show.
Hey, good for you. Riva, to save us a lot of time on mail, I know that we're going to get requests from all over. So where may people obtain a copy of this book, 4 Days, 40 Hours?
In two places, from leading bookstores, such as Doubleday, Walden's, Brentano's, and Macy's, or by writing us directly. Just send $5 to 4 Days, 40 Hours, Cambridge, Massachusetts.
Cambridge, Mass. Will handle it, huh? Okay, well, thank you very much, Riva, and thank you, imposters, for being here with us on To Tell the Truth. You're just fine.
In addition to the cash awards, our first team of challengers will receive for the lady in his life exquisite golden tassel jewelry by Sarah Coventry. A necklace with golden tone chains converts to a bracelet and matching earrings, all designed by Sarah Coventry. Our second team will receive a Fashion 220 glamour case filled with individualized, moisturizing Fashion 220 cosmetics, including cleansing cream, makeup, lipstick, rouge, and eyeshadow.
Martha Mitchell was just telling me she was kind of nervous this morning when she first started this thing. Well, Martha, you're batting 500.
Well, that's wonderful.
That's better than Ted Williams does, you know.
Really?
At his height, at the very best. Can't do any better than bat 500. You want to try again tomorrow?
Oh, I'd love to.
Listen, you're stuck for the whole week. You promised us. And we're going to see you again tomorrow. Friends, take care. Panel, thanks.
Transportation and other considerations provided by Chevrolet, featuring the 1971 Chevelle. America's most popular mid-sized car, new bumpers and grills, same solid, dependable performance at a Chevrolet price. Hotel accommodations, courtesy of the luxurious Park Sheraton Hotel, home of the famous Mermaid Room, right in the heart of Manhattan and convenient to everything. Prizes or product mentions are furnished and or paid for by the manufacturers or supplier of the products or services identified on this program. This is Johnny Olson speaking for To Tell the Truth, a Mark Goodson, Bill Cotton production.